Do I like that? I'm not sure yet. Well, hello my beauties and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 43 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. Netherlands. It's early. If I talk weird and a little low on energy, it's because it's early. But yeah, today my first impression with the Beauty Glazed Melon Palette. Here she is. And I didn't feel like doing my base first, hence the fact that I look like this. I have all four in this bundle. And there are at least two videos up already. I will link them underneath the cards. One with the Lemon Palette, which is an all yellow palette. And then with the Mint Palette, which is a dupe for the Huda Beauty Neony Green. Or something, and I think this is the dupe for the other one. I'm not sure though. That's my guess. What I'm going to do in just a second is swatch. And then I'm going to show you a look. And at the end of the video, give you my thoughts on this palette. If I think it's worth it and all that goodness. I will leave the seller where I bought it. Because I bought these on AliExpress. I will leave the seller down below in my description box. You can buy them individually. But you can also buy them in a bundle. So yeah, that's basically it, I think. I don't know. Again, it's early. So let me get a sip of coffee first. Okay. I'm going to swatch her. I feel like I'm forgetting a lot. I just don't know what. I'm going to swatch her. I'm going to go row by row. I'm going to start here and then I'm going to go like that. She's going to be swatched on a clean bare arm. Let me get a makeup thingy, towelie, whatever. Why can I not? Okay. So here's the color story. She swatches nicely. This one looks to be a little bit patchy, but reds usually are when swatching. So yeah. Looking in the swatches, the two oranges and the two pinks look really close together. I saw that with the other palettes as well that are in this range. But the funny thing was that when I put them on my eye, you could tell a difference even though it was slight. So looking at this, the way the palette is looking, the orange... one is a lighter, one is a darker. And from the pinks, one is more blue than the other. I hope that makes sense. I already have an idea what I want to do. I want to do a two-toned look again because I really like those. So yeah, one crease is going to be orange, I think. And then the other one pink. And I don't really know what to do with the shimmers yet. Maybe I will do one pink eye and one orange eye. Or, yeah, that could be fun. One pink and one orange. Or maybe I will flip the shimmers. I'm not sure yet, but I am going to prime my eyes with the Smashbox Lid Primer in Light. Let me get my mirror even where I need it. Well, it's so early. It's not even funny. Now, I have been looking for a good eye primer for a long, long time. I used to use drugstores. The one from Catrice, the one in the tube, is nice. The Essence... This one, the Color Boost, is also really nice. But those two are very sheer. And... higher end, I do have to say that I can see the difference. The other two are very nice. I like this one better than the MAC Paint Pot at the moment, at least. So, yeah, if you're looking for a good eyeshadow base, this is definitely one to try. I know it's more expensive, but it's a very, very good eyeshadow base. If you need drugstore options, again, the Catrice one or the one from Essence are both very good. They are just... very, very sheer color-wise. Just so you know. Okay. Eyes are primed. I'm going to let it sit for just a little. So it can kind of set a little bit. I'm also going to clean my arm. Otherwise I will forget. Because I know how I am. The shimmer swatched really, really nicely, by the way. Because this is a first impression, I will not use the NYX Glitter Primer in my underneath my shimmers. Usually I do. I will just try them dry first and then spray. Yeah, I think we're ready to put some eyeshadow on. I'm going to start with Orange. But I want a bigger, fluffier brush, so let me get one because I grabbed my small ones, but not my bigger ones. I'm going to start with the darkest of the orange. And then after that, probably use the lightest one. I'm going to start with a fluffier brush. And I'm going to tap it on my eye, but I'm going to tap it low. Because this will set my eyeshadow base while I'm at it. I'm going to dip in and then just make sure it's not patchy. So I'm going to go over lightly. Very pretty. I'm going to try and blend out the edge just a tiny bit. Then I'm going to dip into the lighter orange. And I'm going to put that on top. First tapping motions a little bit because my base is still a bit tacky. And then gently blend. I will use a little bit of the color, the top color, to blend. And make sure it's nice. These shadows blend really, really well. There's not a lot of gradient there, but I think I can use that red one for that. So I'm taking a smaller, fluffy whatever brush. I'm going to dip into the red matte. I can show you, but it's just a red matte. I'm going to use that to darken up the outer corner. But because I don't want to lose the orange, I'm probably going to put the orange back on top again. I'm also going to kind of work it into the crease a bit. I'm tilting my head and I'm concentrating this on the top edge to blend. Yeah, I'm going to dip into the darkest of the oranges first. And just put it on top. Blend even more. Then the lightest of the oranges. Cute. Let me do the same on the other eye, but then with the pinks. So first I'm going to go into the bluer based pink. Which is this one. Which is a little bit darker. Then I'm going to use this one to blend out and that one probably to darken up the crease because, yeah, I can do that, so that's good. I actually want to use the same brush, so let me just clean it off in between. I have a towel here that I clean my brushes off in between use. So first the darkest of the pinks. I'm going to tap it on again. And it's basically the same thing as, well, the other eye, but just with different shades. Now I'm going to go into the lighter pink. Switching brushes, going to the red. And the nice thing about this red is that it doesn't really transform the orange. So I can use it to deepen up that. I can also use it to deepen up this look. Okay, so I need to deepen up that crease a little bit more. And then blend up. A little bit of the darkest orange first, and then the lightest. Okay, I'm going to go back to the pinks again. I'm going first into the darkest of the pink. It's basically going to go on top of that red. And also blending up. Then the lightest of the pinks. I'm taking my very big fluffy favorite brush. I'm just going to blend over everything here. Clean it off and do the same here. Shimmer time. I don't know. I do know, however, that I want yellow in the beginning of both eyes. That I do know. So let me start with that. Let me get a small brush. And I want to use all the shimmers because they are all very, very pretty. I think these will be prettier sprayed, but I'm not sure. So I'm going to grab the yellow one. I'm going to use it dry first, see what it does. It's going to go in a corner. Pretty, okay. Let's spray it for the other side and see if that makes a difference. Not really. I do, however, am going to use the glitter glue. Why? Because I want to get a sharper, kind of a cut creasy line. And for that, I need my glitter glue. So I'm going to use that. I think I'm going to do pink and then orange. So I'm going to plop the glitter glue on my eye. Now also, I haven't used these shimmers yet with a glitter primer, so I'm actually curious to see how they will perform. Okay, I'm going to go in, what did I say, pink here. So I'm going to go into the pink shimmer. Let's see, I'm going to press it on top. Yeah, that's the same effect as if I would spray these. I do have fallout though, so I'm glad I did my eyes first. They are a bit crumbly in the pan, or at least this pink is. Does not really matter though, but I'm dipping in and then picking up the kick up I have. Okay, then here I need to blend it as well. So I'm going to dip in one side in the pink, other side in the yellow. I'm just going to flip, I'm going to pull the yellow on top first, then flip and put the pink on top. I do, however, think I want more yellow, so I'm going to pull the yellow more on top of the pink. For the outer corner, I'm grabbing the red, the matte red. I'm going to basically blend a little bit of that pink shimmer to pull over. And blend the crease a little so it's nice. Do I like that? I'm not sure yet. But let's do the other side first. I'm going to go into the orange shimmer. Put a little bit too much glitter glue on my eye, so I need more shadow to make sure it doesn't stick everywhere. Okay, then the same as the other side, yellow on one side of my brush, orange on the other side, and I'm going to first pull the yellow over. Yeah, and then on the border, I'm just going to flip my brush and tap and drag, and that's the way I'm going to blend them, basically. Okay, I'm going to use the red matte here on the outer corner as well. And a little bit of the orangey shimmer. I want these mattes a little bit more yellow. So what I'm going to do with my fluffy brush, I'm going to go lightly into the yellow matte. I'm going to blend it over the orange to kind of give it the same yellowness as that shimmer has. A little bit brighter. I think that's better. Okay, I'm going to do the rest of my face. And then I will be back to finish off the bottom eyes. Yes. So hold on tight. Hold on tight, I'll be right back. Base makeup is on. Let's do the bottom of the eyes. I'm going to start with the mattes. I have here a flattish brush. I'm going to go into the orange. First, the darkest of the orange. I'm going to pull it underneath my eye. Let me get a different brush to blend a little bit better. And a little bit of that red on just on the tip. And a little bit higher. Yeah, I like that. A little bit of that yellow. Cute. Let's do the same on the other eye. So first let me get this brush for the darkest of the pinks. Then the red. And then the lightest of the pink. The shimmers are going to go now. And I am going to use... I'm going to spray them. So first, let's get into the pink. Yes. Let's get my brush with a little bit of orange. Yes. Different brush. I'm going to go into the yellow shimmer. Okay. Going to do the same on the other side, but then with the orange and the yellow. And then I'm going to blend with a little bit of that lightest pink. Okay, I'm going to connect the pink there to the upper part, because I forgot. Eye pencils. I have pink and orange. I could also do yellow. Let's do yellow. So I have here the Essence Electric Vibes in Neon Love. It's the only yellow that I have. I also have here a golden one from Essence, which is unfortunately not really good, but I think I can put it on top of the yellow to get a little bit of a, I don't know, more along the lines of the inner part of my eye. Yeah, I like that. Okay, I am going to do liner mascara, falsies, lippy, and I will be back and show you the finished look and tell you a little bit about the palette, how I feel and all that goodness. So hold on tight, don't go anywhere. Everything is on and here is the finished look. I like how the look turned out. I like it a lot. Oh, before I forget, the falsies I have on are the ones from AliExpress in the style L12. I will leave them down in my description box. And the lip combination is a lip pencil from Catrice, lip foundation pencil in the color I Take You to the Chocolate Shop, and on top of that I put a Catrice itchy nose. No, not itchy nose. The Generation Plump and Shine in the color Shimmery Goldstone. I could have done a pink or an orange, but I kind of wanted to let the eyes speak for themselves. Hence the fact that I picked more of a nudie color. But yeah, let me go over what I think. What I think is actually that I don't really like the shimmers on top of the glitter glue. Or maybe I just used way too much glitter glue on this eye, because it seems to be breaking up. I don't know if you can see it, but it seems to be... I have a magnifying mirror here, so I can see it, but... Yeah, it kind of seems to be... I don't know, skipping. It could very well be that it is because I put them on top of a glitter glue, maybe too much glitter glue. Because the previous times I didn't have a problem when I used them sprayed. I can try that though. So let me get a flat brush. Not you, because I used you for the glitter glue. Let me get a little bit of that orange, spray it and put it on top and see what that does. Because again, it looks like it's cracking, which is weird. Now, I have by no means a young eye. You know, my eye is also 43, so yeah. Yeah, doesn't really seem to help. Let me get the yellow. But the yellow also seems to be cracking a little bit. And I spray the yellow. The pink doesn't seem to have... a lot of trouble. It's just the orange, and I don't know if it is my application or that shade maybe is a little bit less quality than the rest. I do really like the color story though. I think color story wise, this might even be my favorite, just because I can do what I did now. I could do a cut crease, I could do a very simple monochromatic look, I could do just a shimmer and then blend it out a little bit. I can do a yellow look, you know, so I can really play with this this palette. I'm glad that they put in the red to deepen up both colors. And the yellow, yeah, I don't mind the yellow. I haven't used it on its own yet. But yeah, the mattes blended out nicely. The shimmers are pretty as well. They work nice. I do feel that they are a little bit more difficult to pick up. This shimmer formula is the same. The berry palette that I played with the other day has a different, has this shimmer formula, but also another one. So this one is a little bit more, if you feel it, it's a little bit more soft. And there, it's very pretty. I just, yeah, maybe this is even a shade that you need to put on with your finger, you know? My falsies in the way. I don't like doing that. However, you can also use a sponge tip applicator, then you're a little bit more precise. But it almost feels like these shimmers are better used with your finger or a sponge tip applicator. I'm going to try that though. So I will let you know if that is better than what I did now. But yeah, I think this is actually, color story wise, the favorite of the bunch. The quality is nice. And I don't like saying that, but especially for the price, then the quality is amazing. Because the price per palette is, I think, €2.50 or something like that. So it is very, very cheap. But the quality of all four palettes is way higher than what you would expect. So yeah, I think that's it, guys. Again, I will leave the information of the seller down below. I will leave the link down below so you can go and check them out. They're cheapest in the bundle because then you only have to pay shipping once. I think that's it. I don't really know what to say about it. I'm glad that I have this bundle. I'm very happy that I bought the bundle and not just stuck with only the yellow palette, because I actually think I will have a lot of fun, especially with this one. So yeah, I think that's it, guys. Let me know down below what you think of this look. Do you have the palettes? Do you want the palettes? Do you have the original Yehuda neons? And do they kind of compare what you can see to these? Let me know down in the comment section below. I am going to stop filming and get ready for work. So yeah, thank you so much for watching. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening, and I will see you soon in my next one. Bye, guys. Why am I itchy?